What is up, guys? All Gas TV here, and we're back for another one of these playoff prediction videos. And we are one Sunday. Let me rephrase this. We are 2 weeks away from Super Bowl 53. We are one whole Sunday away, from knowing this matchup. And that is this Sunday. Here's their matchups right now on the screen. In the NFC, you have the Saints and Rams. That game is going to be in New Orleans. And they have the Chiefs and Patriots. That game is going to be in Kansas City. I want to predict those two. Talk about both matchups here. Let's get into this here. Interesting fact about both these matchups here that are going on this weekend. These matchups actually happen in the regular season. And if you really want to think about it, there's the scores could be exactly the same. And let's see, the Patriots took on the Chiefs. I want to say week seven. No, it was week six. It was back-to-back Sunday night games for the Chiefs. And that game finished 43-40. Tyreek went, I should save these facts, but we're going to go ahead and go over them. Tyreek Hill went off with 142 receiving yards, 3 touchdowns. Sony Michel kind of went off with 106 yards and 2 touchdowns. Patrick Mahomes was Patrick Mahomes. So in week 7, the Patriots did win by 3, but it was late field goal as game expired. And let's see here. I do believe the other matchup did happen week 11 or maybe week 12. Is it going to load? Might have been week 12. Might have been before that. It was before that. I don't know when this matchup happened. There it is. And then the other matchup, the Saints, in the same location here, took on the Rams for a final score of 45-35. Jared Goff threw for 391, 3 touchdowns. Alvin Kamara had himself an okay day, 19 carries, 82 yards, 2 touchdowns. Michael Thomas went off with 12 receptions for 211 yards and a touchdown. So, what's probably getting into these matchups here. Conference championship. Here we go. First matchup we have here, NFC title game. This game's the first game actually of title championship weekend. This game will happen at 2:05 on Fox in New Orleans. A little bit of information you need to know here. Jared Goff went this season threw for 4,688 yards, 32 touchdowns. I don't know why it's that important. Drew Brees, the other quarterback, threw for 3,992 yards, 32 touchdowns, same number of touchdowns. Todd Gurley went off. Todd Gurley still could be a little bit questionable with that knee, but we saw last week, not really questionable. He's had 17 touchdowns on the year, and Alvin Kamara, I mean, not quite 1,000 yards, but he had 14 touchdowns on the year. Michael Thomas and Robert Woods were teams both leading receivers. Thomas had 125 receptions on the year. Robert Wood had a breakout year. There's that number. 86 receptions for 1,219 yards and 6 touchdowns. I want to take a look at this here. The Rams are 6-2 away from Los Angeles. The Saints are 6-2 at home. And like I said, when this matchup happened, week 9, maybe week 10, if I don't remember, probably just rewind actually here. The Saints to come victorious. The Saints defense, ever since this matchup, has been top notch, not allowing a lot of points. The Rams also have been the normal Rams, going in and out, putting up big points and whatnot. The thing about the Rams is their defense is a tad bit iffy, and you can't really be like, yes, no, Rams here, Rams there. Saints defense has been stepping in up late. These young guys have been proving their big playmakers. The Saints did get off to a slow start last week against the Eagles. They put on the finishing touches. The Rams just took care of the Cowboys. In my opinion, we could be seeing a decent game between these two. Do I see another 45 points put up by either team? I don't, because it's playoff football and these teams need to realize, hey, we ain't going to be putting up 45 points each. So this ain't no Chiefs-Rams game for Monday Night Football from like week 12. So I think the score prediction, Rams will put up 21. Saints will put up 28. I mean, kind of a high-scoring affair, a little bit more than a 3.5-point spread, but I feel like the Saints will get this done. Drew Brees will lead the team to the Super Bowl. Yeah, that's my opinion here. Also, I like to put another fact. If you want to go back in history here, you're going to do this 10-year challenge. What's similar between these two Saints teams? Go back to 2009 when the Saints won the Super Bowl. I know you can say Bounty Gate and whatnot, but their three losses in the regular season were Cowboys, Buccaneers, Panthers that year. Want to know who their three losses are this year in the regular season? Cowboys, Buccaneers, Panthers. 13-3 record, same quarterback at the helm. Do I think this is the same season? We'll see that in the prediction for the Super Bowl. So we are done with this matchup here. We get to go on to the next one. And this one could be a fun one. AFC title game. This game will be played at 5:40 Central Time on CBS. This game has the chance of being the coldest game in Arrowhead history with, I want to say, negative 15 feel like temperature. Let's start talking about the stats on the year. Tom Brady threw for 4,355 yards, 29 touchdowns, 11 interceptions. Patrick Mahomes, you pretty much know what he did this year. He threw for 5,097 yards, 50 touchdowns, 12 interceptions. Beast. MVP, that'll be in discussion for another day. Running attack, we ain't going to talk about the Chiefs running attack because they still have Kareem Hunt as our leading rusher here on ESPN. But Sony Michel was the leading rusher for the New England Patriots with 931 yards and 6 touchdowns. Leading receiver for the Patriots goes to Julian Edelman with 856. And then you got Tyreek Hill, who had 1,479 yards, 12 touchdowns. The Patriots are taking this underdog role right now. I don't know why the hell they're doing that. This matchup, when I first started thinking about this weekend, this is the toughest thing I have to predict. Saints game, yes and no, difficult to predict. This Chiefs-Patriots game, difficult to predict. Yet Patrick Mahomes, who's having an MVP caliber season, second career playoff game, threw 50 touchdowns in the regular season. Looked okay last week against the Colts. They relied on Damian Williams to run the ball, Tyreek Hill to do Tyreek Hill things, and their defense kind of stepped up. The Patriots just destroyed the Chargers last week. Tom Brady was playoff Tom Brady. The running game kind of stepped up. The defense, well, the Chargers had to show up before the defense can actually do anything. It's Belichick Brady playoffs. Tom Brady, 41 years old. Sub-zero temperatures. Last quarterback I think that played in sub-zero temperatures that were 40 years old, Brett Favre. NFC Championship game 2007. Again, Brett Favre threw that game away. He had an opportunity to take on Tom Brady in the Super Bowl. He wasn't 40, he was 38. Do we see Tom Brady play like the playoff Tom Brady against this Chiefs offense? And does this Chiefs defense? Or does this Chiefs defense show up like a week ago when they played the Colts? Is Patrick Mahomes going to be the same Patrick Mahomes we've seen all year? Patriots this year are 3-5 on the road. Their 5 losses this season came on the road. Let's review those losses for the Patriots. Can't you ready for this? A loss on the road to Jacksonville. A loss on the road to Detroit. A loss on the road to Tennessee. A loss on the road to Miami. A loss on the road in Pittsburgh. All 5 of those teams didn't make the playoffs. Teams they played that made the playoffs this year. Houston, they won by 7. Indianapolis, they won by 14. Chiefs, they won by 3. Bears, they won by 7. And in the playoffs, they won by 13 over the Chargers. As I'm sitting here, I'm thinking, the Patriots are going to go and win this game. Because the 4 Chiefs lost this year on the road, primetime against the Patriots. On the road, primetime against the Rams. At home, primetime against the Chargers. On the road, primetime against the Seahawks. The average loss, there's 8, 14 divided by 4. Is roughly 3 points. When it comes to big moments, the Chiefs tend to lose. Andy Reid in the playoffs. Maybe he's going to take what he saw from the White House this week from Donald Trump giving Clemson players fast food, like, hey, that's our goal. We want to go there. I need me some fast food from for free. I'm just winning the Super Bowl. I have my prediction here. And we're going to reveal it. One side at a time. I feel like Tom Brady and the Patriots against the Chiefs defense, who last week stopped the Colts with 13 points, looked all year to be iffy. Let's take a look at what they won by. They won by 10 against the Chargers week 1. They won by 5 against the Steelers week 2. They won by 11 against the Niners week 3. Won by 4 against the Broncos week 4. 16 points against the Jaguars week 5. 35 points against the Bengals week 7. Against the Broncos again, they won by 7. Against the Browns, they won by 16. Against the Cardinals, they won by 12. Against the Raiders, they won by 7. And then, of course, they ended the year out against the Raiders with a 32-point win. Let's rule out the fact here that they They. I mean, they gave up an average of 20. I want to say 24 points a game. I think they're going to give up 32 to the Patriots. Tom Brady's going to show up. Tom Brady's going to play like Tom Brady in the playoffs. What do I think that the Chiefs put up? Yeah, talking about Patrick Mahomes, Damian Williams, Travis Kelce, Sammy Watkins, Tyreek Hill on offense going up against this Patriots defense, man. I think they're going to put up 45. I think the Colts is going to get to Brady at some point. Of course, it's going to get to every player. And I feel like it's going to be a 13-point win for your Kansas City Chiefs. That puts my Super Bowl matchup right now. It's the Kansas City Chiefs and the New Orleans Saints. We almost got that rematch from that Monday Night Football game that was supposed to be in Mexico City. It's not going to happen unless the NFL is like, hey, make it happen. They don't. I don't believe the NFL rigs things. You can go ahead and comment down in the comment section if you believe that. But I do believe the Chiefs are going to be victorious here. The Patriots are going to choke. The Patriots have lost in the 5 road games in the playoffs. And that sounds bad in the last 19 years. But they can lose on the road. They lost to the Jets in the playoffs. They're going to lose to the Chiefs. The Chiefs are going to be your AFC representative. The Saints are going to be your NFC representative. That is my Super Bowl matchup prediction here. That took longer than it should have. It took 18 minutes for me to explain that. But that's what I think happening, bro. And just my luck is going to be the exact opposite. We're going to get a rematch of the 2001 Super Bowl with the greatest show on turf going up against Tom Brady. So, you know, that's probably what's going to happen. But I feel like the Chiefs and the Saints are going to be victorious. And that's going to be it for me today. I rambled on for 2-1. If you enjoy this, leave a like. If you don't enjoy this, dislike. I don't care. Comment down in the comment section your prediction of scores. Subscribe. I might be live during this Chiefs Patriots game. I don't know yet. Yeah, that's gonna be it for me. I'll see you guys 2 weeks from now for Super Bowl Sunday prediction matchup. Peace out.